Hello everyone and welcome back to Eve Market, your weekly look at the Amar Market. We can just straight start off with the minerals. We can start with titanium. It seems to be still going down on price. It's 20 days going down and 5 is pretty low spot for today here, below 460. So titanium is still dropping in price. Let's look at the prices for the sellers. We're sitting at, that's the first one. Here it is, 478 for the first titanium sellers or sellers. Yeah, and for the buyers we're sitting at 463. It's a little bit of a drop since last week. We were at 469. So it's not really much of a change on that price. Alright, next one, ferrite. Ferrite seems to be went a little bit up. It seems pretty stable around the 12. There's not much movement in there. So let's look at the seller's price. 1190 for the sellers, and on the buyers sitting 1180. Last week price was sitting at 1119 for the buyers, so it's only dropped a very little bit. Seems that mineral price seems to be a little bit stabilizing, huh? Alright, let's look at it for Maxelon. While stabilizing, Maxelon is going up in price a bit. Seems to be a little bit flattening out here. 20 days starting to fall too slowly. Let's look at the prices for the sellers. Where are we at? 39.80 for the sellers. On the buyers, we're sitting at 37 is. That's going a little bit up in price, at least for these two, the 37 and 36.80. But if these getting fulfilled, we're gonna drop straight to 36. And the 36 is lower than last week. Last week we were sitting at 36.12. So basically it went up a little bit. Alright, next one. Noxidium is still on the downtrend. It had a little bit up this week, the end of last week, after the drop, and seems to be dropping now again below the 750. There's a spot there. Well, at least the 5 days dropping, 20 days still going down. Let's look at the prices for the sellers. 779, just below it. No, just below the 780. Sorry, just a little bit below that price, and for the buyers in 729.23. Last week was in at 750, so it's definitely dropped in about 20 SK unit. And then we're going off. What's the next one again? Zynrit was really dropping every time. Zynrit is still dropping, surprisingly. Looks like there's still definitely more supply of Zynrit on the market. So 5 days dropping and 20 days dropping in price of it. Look at the prices. 705 for the sellers. And 628. Of 682.28 for the buyers. It's a pretty good drop. Well, last week we're sitting 709.62. So it definitely has dropped a lot. I don't know where these drops coming from, these, but apparently sites may be easy to find for everyone. I don't know. Let's go on for Megasite. Megasite still dropping. Wow, amazing. It's sitting between 19 and 1800. The 5 day seems to be flattening out a bit. Well, the 20-day is still dropping. Maybe it's finding stabilized point. We'll see soon. Let's look at the prices. 1949.97. Well, the next one is 1954. And for the buyers, we're seeing 1822, just above that. That's a little bit of a drop. Last week price was sitting 1852. Now 22, so that dropped a little bit on that price again. Surprised these null sec minerals keep dropping in price. Well, the last one of the minerals is Morphite. It's gonna be handy if it loads up. Apparently not Iron Crest. I'll be right back. Right, back. Right, for the last one, Morphite. Let's look what this one is doing. Morphite is, yeah, same story here. It's still dropping in price. 5 and 20, they are dropping. Sitting now around the 8,000 per unit. For the sellers, 7,999. So just below the 8,000. And for the buyers, 7,540, just above that. That went a little bit up since last week. Last week was saying 7,400 for the buyers. That's 140 increase in that price. Alright, let's go on for some salvage. Look at the armor plates. It seems pretty stable. For the last few weeks, it seems to be a little bit of a drop today in the price. Maybe someone sold a lot to buyers. On the price, it's 172,000 for the sellers, but it's not really a lot. But that's the lowest price. And for the buyers, sitting at 163,263. That has dropped pretty a lot. Last week, we're sitting 171,800. So that has a pretty dropped a few thousand in that price. Burn logic circuits is really bouncing. That's lowest point somewhere below the 32, almost hitting, almost 31 even, and scrolling a bit back up around the 32,000. 20 days still dropping, catching up with it. On the prices, for the sellers, there's one here for 32,000. 048, and next one is standing straight at of just below the 35,000 even. On the buyers, 32,000 per unit. That's about 1,000 increase and it's last week price. That's about just above the 31,000. Fried interface circuits had a big drop. Went up again, then it dropped and seems to be going up again in price. And not really finding a spot recently. It had for a while pretty stable price, but now it's jumping around again. So for the sellers, we're sitting at from decent amount, 4,697 for the seller's price, and for the buyers, 3,863. The buyer's price went down a lot. It went down with about 300. Last week we were sitting at 4,166. So that has dropped a pretty decent amount. Melted capacitor consoles. Wow. Alright. That took a nosedive here in price. It came from around 6,800 and it took a nosedive towards the 5,000. So, and you can also straight see there was a very huge spike here on the amount that been sold on the market. So probably someone left a whole load towards the market and sold them straight. And which is making this price drop a lot. So that's very low. For the sellers are still sitting at 7,700, just below that on the sellers, and for the buyers we're sitting at 5,207. Last week we're sitting at 6,815. So that has dropped a lot, and you can see it's all back here in a graph just above the 5,000. Someone has sold a lot on the market. Let's go on for the last one this week. That's the trip power circuits. Still pretty stable. It has a drop. It seems to be crawling back up in price. It's just above the sitting around 126, 127, it looks like. So that one is crawling a little bit up. For the last 3 days, pretty stable on price. Let's look for the sellers. Don't seem to have really decent amount. Only 27,200, just above it. And for the buyers, 125,754. Last week was trading flat at 127. So it has dropped about 1,200, 1,300 in price. Alright, I'm not going to look anymore at the terahertz meter materials, because they have seemed to found pretty spot on the market. So I'm not having anything more to look at. So this was this week's look at the MR market. And I will see you guys next week. Fly safe.